Beginner to Pro Jewelry Tips, the Orion Micro Welder mPulse. It's very simple, and there are two major pieces. There's a machine at the bottom, and then there is a screen and stylus holder at the top. There's a switch here, and everything else connects very simply. This is a stylus, which I'm going to talk about at the end of this video. And then it connects to the machine so that things work in sync. It's plugged into the back like this. And then all you have to do is switch. And the light comes on for the screen. And this screen, it protects your eyes, much like the welding masks that they use. And here, to select the power, it's very simple. You can go up, higher the wattage, the stronger it is. And then you can move down, lowest being 5. Most delicate pieces just require 7.5 to 12.5. And then all you have to do is press play. I'm going to demonstrate how easy it is to operate this machine by welding together a thin jump ring to connect two pieces of fine chain. You make sure that the jump ring, the two ends are touching together as you would if you were soldering. And then clip on the ground so that electricity could conduct through. Then all you have to do is touch where you want it to be welded, like this. I'm going to pause here to show you the screen. It's gone black. It does this automatically as you are welding to protect your eyes. And then it goes back to light green again. So here, it is welded, and you'll see that there is something that looks like fire scale. That happens because of the oxygen being burnt in the high temperature. So now all you have to do is to polish it or use a wire brush. It's very simple, and it is done. Sometimes it gets a bit warped. You can straighten that out with a pair of pliers. And if you find that in some corners or under the clip needs to be polished, you can touch it up again. And there you have, and that's how easy it is. Far easier than if you were soldering. So here I'm doing one where there's wire up top and with a stone. If I was using flame, I would have to protect that either with coating or submerge it while I'm using the flame on top. Again, I make sure that the two ends of the jump ring are touching, like here. Make sure that that's done. And I don't have to protect the stone, which is great. And make sure that I know where the seam is, like that, so I can check. And have the alligator clip not right over it when I'm about to weld. Again, I put it under the light, behind the screen like this, and I'm ready. Perhaps this is a good time to talk about an addition that you can purchase, which is the argon gas with a regulator and a tank. It might set you back about $300-$400. And what that does is there's a hookup where as soon as you weld, there's going to be a puff of argon gas that blows on it that gets rid of the oxygen and reduces the amount of scaling that you're going to have. It's not an absolute preventative measure, but it reduces it significantly. But it's easy for me to just brush it like this to remove any. And that is a very small jump ring, and that looks great. I'm going to also add a smaller, I think this is 4mm, and I can use even smaller jump rings. And sometimes I can attach two chains together with tiny links. And that's what it looks like with a smaller jump ring. And this is a bezel set birthstone. I'm going to do the same thing. Sometimes it takes a couple of times to weld because I've lowered the power or I'm instinctively withdrawing it before it can do its job, the stylus. And so there it is. And now my alligator clip is stuck because there's so little room and it got hot. But you can take it off and redo it if necessary. But there it is, it's done. And now all I have to do is brush. Should it be the case that it got bumpy, take a pair of pliers and just press down because it's melted with the alligator clip. Here you have it. And here I've added one more with a different size of jump ring, another birthstone to this collection. And with the larger one, I put 7.5. This is a good time to talk about the stylus. They come in, the electrodes come in different thicknesses depending on the precision that you need and how much power. Over time, the electrode gets a bit gunky with a backsplash or it gets dull, and you just sand it using a sanding disc, and there gets it pointy again. And the stylus is easy to open. There you have it, just screws on top. And the electrode over time wears down like this. I've been using this for a long time. It lasts quite a bit. And to put it back in, all I have to do, outside there's a marker so you know how much it should stick out. And there, I've got that. And then you just twist it tightly, like this. I'm going to double check before closing. There you have it. And then all you have to do is twist it and it'll click in place. And this is stylus is ready to go for your next job. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comment section and I will reply. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe.